my beautiful people, my magical rubies. Okay, so guys, this topic is so important to me because
me as a woman,
okay, and even as a young girl, I went through things with, you know, just
checking on your weight and
comparing yourself to others and yada yada yada. So it's really crazy right now about how us women, girls, are comparing our bodies, trying to make or get celebrity, trying to look like celebrities. You know, we're not trying to look like them, but comparing ourselves, okay? It's really dangerous, okay? And I just wanted to do a video about it to help you women, help you ladies, help you girls know that you are beautiful as you are. And I know that it's hard sometimes, okay? So many people are trying to
obtain these bodies
to look like celebrities, okay? I always look at my notes. They look at celebrities, Kim Kardashian, I don't know, Beyonce, I don't know, Kate Winslet, who knows? They look at celebrities and they're just like, oh my gosh, you know, like your body's so nice, and or even just vixens on Instagram, video vixens, whatever it may be. Women tend to look at them and just like, oh my gosh, I wish I had that. I wish I had that. And it's very unfortunate, okay? And we have to
understand that most
of these people who I do, you know, I respect all women. I don't care what work you get done. I don't care. I respect all women. Everybody has a choice to do whatever they want to do, okay? But we have these people like Kim Kardashian, all of the Kardashians, okay? I follow Kim Kardashian. I admire her hustle. I admire her work ethic. I admire her. You know, yes, she was born into certain things. That's fine, but she still is also a hard worker. Her sister, Kylie Jenner, you know,
they have these bodies that are not
real, okay? They have these bodies as to where they are completely frail, thin, all everywhere except for the ass, okay? That is not normal. That is not a natural body to me, okay? You can't be so thin and then have this big ass. It's just not possible. So you have girls and women out there on the day-to-day basis, and they're looking at these bodies because people are praising these bodies when they're not real and they're not obtainable by the normal person, by a normal person, okay? And not only do they have, you know, enhanced butts and breasts, you know, they have these boobs that are just like, you know, they look, they're just sitting up in their clothing. And they had all these kids, and it's just not real. And a lot of these moms as well. Now, let me tell you this. Us moms are killing it with our bodies. Like, we are looking amazing, okay? We are beautiful. We are toned. Our breasts are still nice. Our butts are still nice. Like, okay, we got it too, right? But we look at the Kardashians and the other celebrities, and we're like, oh my gosh, they have four kids, and they look like this, and they're like that. Honey, it's not real, okay? And then they have the best of the best surgeons. They have the best of the best chefs in their home. They don't have everyday stresses. They don't have their kids all day. So it's a complete difference, a different story when all those things play into factor. So I just want you guys to really know that what you see on social media and in these celebrities, these women's bodies, is not real.
You know, a lot of people were saying Alec
Baldwin's wife, who I adore, Hilaria. I love her, okay? She has a lot of kids, but she was also born extremely skinny, like extremely skinny. That's her beauty, okay? That's the way she was born, and that's her body. So when she has that baby, it's easy for her to pop back. And that is natural, because I don't think Hilaria has had any work done. She's also active, of course, with all those kids. She does yoga. So she also just has a naturally frail body. So what I'm saying also is that everybody's body is completely different, and we cannot continue to try to look like someone else, okay? I mean, yeah, you can pay for it, but, you know, just for you guys who don't want to go out there and have surgery, if you're beautiful
and you can
obtain whatever you want to obtain, and make sure you maintain your own beauty and your own body, okay? God created us individually for a reason, okay? If God wanted us all to look the same, women, you know, black, white. I'm speaking about body images, but I'm saying if God wanted us all to look the same, and he's actually in control, he created everybody and everything, then he would have made it to us to where we all have one mother, we all have one father, and we all look exactly the same. That's the way God would have made it if he wanted us all to have big butts and big boobs and or flat boobs and or flat chest and flat butt or cellulite stretch marks, everybody. He made it to where we all are different. We all are unique. Okay? And that's what he wanted. That is the purpose and the beauty of people. People. P-E-O-P-L-E. That is the beauty of people, not the beauty of one. Okay? And one, what one should look
like. A prototype. Not real. Let's keep going, my loves.
But no, you know, there's billions of moms, there's billions of dads, and we're all supposed to be different. We're all supposed to have a different nose. We're all supposed to have different lips. We're all supposed to have a different butt, curves. We're all supposed to look different, okay? That is the beauty of us, okay? So, ladies, I know that this world tells you that those stretch marks or that cellulite or that big butt or that flat butt is wrong. You know, but you are beautiful. And I can understand also from a woman's perspective of, yes, comparing yourself to others. That's why I do not watch social media. That's why I do not watch, you know, certain things, because I know I am beautiful. I know that my curves are beautiful. I know that everything God gave me is beautiful. And if I continue to watch social media, and you're automatically going to compare yourself, automatically. Guys, my son is trying to get me to eat this chicken because
he wants a piece of my homemade
pumpkin bread.
Why, Mom?
Why don't you go eat it, Joshy?
Because.
Why don't you? Looking for a finger.
He wants me to eat it, but guys, I don't eat meat
really, okay? But he wants me to eat this. Okay, I'll give you a cake in a second, okay? Let me finish my video and then I'll give you a piece of cake. Okay?
Okay. So, some people can't be thin, some people can't be thick. And it's because it's genetics, it's because that's how we are.
And that's what we should accept, and that's what we should love. No, I can't say if I'm...
No, baby, I don't want the chicken. Okay,
I'll eat it in a second, okay?
Okay.
Every woman
should embrace her body. We all should be embracing our body, even though sometimes we may, you know, you may feel down some days. Everybody, even Rihanna, who is a gorgeous girl, woman, said that she feels down some days. We all are going to feel down some days, because some days we're going to have bad days and some days we're going to have good days. Don't shake the table, baby. And that's normal. That's normal. You know what I mean? Naturally, we want to be
healthy, okay? And I just don't know if
putting all these chemicals and things in here. I don't even know anything about putting the fat. I mean, I guess people say it's your own fat, so you can put it in your own butt, your own lips and stuff. I don't know too much about it.
Mom.
But I just, hold on, Jessie, but I just want women to feel healthy and embrace who they are, okay? Surgery is
fine if you want surgery.
But I think that women, especially young girls, should try to work out, eat healthy, and try to see what their body looks like before they try to change it so quickly, okay? You know, a lot of people say people are going overboard with the BBLs. I don't know. I can't say. I just think that women should know that they're beautiful no matter what. And we're strong and we're courageous and we should continue to support each other. And a big problem is that the world, social media, they put these bodies that are not real on a pedestal. They make, you know, oh my gosh, did you see this? Did you see Kylie Jenner in her thong, her bikini? When
her ass is not real.
Her breast is not real. She has the best of the best surgeons. You know, she can.
She has the best of the best chefs.
They're putting people on a pedestal that are not real. So what is the little girl who is 15 years old or 18 years old in high school gonna think? You know what I mean? Like, what are they gonna think? Everything that they put on the pedestal is not real. It's not real.
Okay? So that is something that we need
to work on as a society and change it.
I'm always going
beyond my notes. I don't even look at my notes a lot, and I'm just going off of it because it does come from my mind. So, like, I'm almost done. But a lot of the people that I tend to admire is Angela Simmons, who's naturally beautiful, naturally curvy. And she's just amazing. I look up to, not look up to, but I admire Tia and Tamara, Tamari or Housley. I admire Gabrielle Union. I admire people who doesn't mind not having what is called,
what is so-called trending on
bodies, okay?
Yeah, I know. And don't think that I hate
surgery, okay? Don't think that I'm against surgery or people who have surgery. Ladies, I support you. I just also want to support the women who don't want to have surgery, and the little girls who are thinking that they have to look like a certain person. I know a beautiful 18-year-old girl. I mentioned this in another video. Beautiful 18-year-old girl, but she's extremely thin, and she just praises the Kardashians' body. She just wants to. Her dream is to go and have their body one day, to have that ass and whatever. And that is just not cool, okay? I'm not blaming anybody, because if the Kardashians or whomever want that ass and they want to have surgery, that's fine. It's up to us as parents to make sure that we tell our girls and our boys what they are and how beautiful they are. But it's important
for these celebrities, to me, to also let these young kids know
this is
not real. I had surgery and yada, yada, yada.
I think that more celebrities need to speak out and say
that they had
surgery and not let these young girls think that it's real, okay? And obtainable, because it's not obtainable. That is my take on surgery, plastic surgery, and how social media
is influencing our young girls today, okay? Love and light to you guys.
I love you. Like, comment, and subscribe. I support all of my queens and kings out there. It doesn't matter if you have surgery or not. I am just trying to go on both sides, okay? And find a balance, okay? Love and light. I'll see you guys later.